I'm sharing that.
So today, students, we are going to discuss about how we can break a glass with virtual lifestyle, and we will be focusing on skill development, talking about skills. There are actually many life skills which are important, and when we are talking about virtual lifestyle, even in contemporary scenario, textual knowledge has taken a back seat, as you all know that classes have hit the airwaves and life skills have come forward as a rescue. People with highest academic records are failing in the times of crisis. Here lies the answer that why skills and skill development is a relevant point today. When I talk of life skills, the very first important life skill which I want you all to ponder upon is self-control, which talks about even-mindedness, composure, equanimity, all that. That will also relate you to perspective taking, which involves that how you can be less involved in conflicts. The third comes communicative skills, which we all deal, me and Dr. Savya, Sachi deal, which is communication skills, which is reading, listening, writing, speaking. And trust me on this, that if you learn nothing from this session, you will certainly learn one thing, which is speaking skill, because you're going to have an exposure by listening. Listening, and again, critical thinking too, because that will demand analysis and evaluation. Next, we will talk about taking on challenges and being self-directed or engaged in learning. So these are the points which I want you all to contemplate. Ma'am, the board is all set for you. We are highly indebted to have you on board with us. So the guest speaker today is Ms. Anam Shuaib. Ma'am hails from Lucknow and currently based in New Delhi. She is an alumna of Miranda House, Delhi University. Ma'am has trained many students, and she is a well-known personality development trainer. We all welcome you, ma'am, on the behalf of Faculty of Engineering and Technology, University of Lucknow. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Lucknow University. Good evening, each one of you. Well, I'm completely thrilled and inspired to talk on this topic today, which I and ma'am actually thought to discuss with all of you here. So now, firstly, the first point which I am going to discuss is, as soon as lockdown did hit and we began the virtual lifestyle, right, starting from pani puri to varieties of cake, we all have become chefs. We all have tried different kind of hairstyles to being comfortable in our own shell. And always remember, children, especially I would say my pretty girls and handsome boys here, because I could see all of you smiling and, you know, have a plan ahead. That with this virtual lifestyle, one thing which we really learned is nothing is impossible. So in this context, I will begin by playing a song, and each one of you try to catch the catchy word from here. Let's see who comes up with. So I'm going to play a song, and let me see if who comes up with it here.
I remember years ago, someone told me I should take caution when it comes to love. I did. and you were strong and I was not. My illusion, my mistake, I was careless, I forgot I did. And now, when all is done, there is nothing to say. You have gone up so effortlessly. You have won, you can go ahead, tell them all I know now. Shout it from the rooftops, write it on the skyline.
Tell them I was high. Okay. Is there anyone who did come out of a catchy word here? Anyone? All right, the word is impossible. And this virtual lifestyle has taught us how we can turn everything from impossible into possible. So can I have my PPT being shared, Ma'am Kaumudi?
Yes, ma'am, we'll do that.
Okay, thank you.
I request the technical assistant, please share the PPT.
Till then, I would like to talk to all of you. Let's wait for the PPT to roll. In this virtual lifestyle, all of us, where we have first been cribbing to now being completely somewhere adjusted, that yes, this is the new normal. Somewhere around, we all have learned to be in the path of how to break a glass. And that is why today I'm here to help you realize how we can still, if not into the path, break the glass ceiling and enter the virtual lifestyle happily, like literally happily. It's not like some, there are my own friends will be like, dude, we really can't go to DLF Cyber Hub, or like, we can't do this, we can't do that. But somehow, if we change our thought process, the where we sit, the place we choose to sit in our virtual class, that all is in our mindset. We can just turn it actually into a cafe. Okay, the PPT is here. Turn impossible into possible. Now students, the first very point I would like to share with all of you is with a story. Few weeks back, I was attending a course on international human resource management. And I literally didn't know that there will be an exam for it. So I was casually hearing it, doing a multitasking at home. And as a result, I received a mail that congratulations, ma'am, and a short para. Now, just like you all, what I did was, I didn't read the full mail. Hearing the congratulations message, I was very glad that yes, I did something. Then one fine day, I received a link that you have a code here because tomorrow you have IHRM exam. And that's when my reality did hit that exam. And I was about to just, you know, go to the director and tell that how sudden, how short. But I went back to the mail and I read there was written that your exam is on this particular date. I had just 12 hours and I somehow know now I have no other option rather than appearing. So I made that in my mind that by crossing my fingers like this, that I should just pass because I thought this international human resource management is certainly not my cup of tea. It's really impossible to get even 70%. So since I had no option of having a hard copy of book, no option of even going to the library and searching few books, all I had was an option to search the syllabus of the exam. I searched it and found. What I did was, for example, there was a theory, individualism versus groupism. What I did was I just quickly checked the example to develop a practical mindset into my mind. With that, I kept on going and I did almost 4 modules. by somewhere around 9 p.m. Unfortunately, there was some tension which erupted at my home and I couldn't go any longer. So I decided to go back to sleep. And then I woke up at 2:45 a.m. because my exam was scheduled at 9 a.m. 2-3 modules were left. I started from the last module so that in between, if there is something which is left, at least the two borders I'm completing, just like all of you last moment you all do. As a result, I went to give the exam, reading all the examples, right? Starting comparing from Japan to USA to our Indian lifestyle. And one thing which I learned was always remember and be confident about the place you live. For example, we all are Indians, so we should be very confident about all the virtual lifestyle formulas we are adapting. I went for the exam, gave the exam, and I thought, may God help. And after 25 days, the result was rolling in my mail, and I topped the exam. I got full marks. And that is what did hit me, that nothing is impossible. If I can do it, children, you all can do it wonderfully well. Remember that. So this is my takeaway. And how? What is the skill that I was able to do? Can I have the next sharing of slide?
Sure, ma'am, we'll do that.
What is the skill to turn everything from impossible into possible? To be the stylist of your own life in this virtual lifestyle. And trust me, there is nothing in the world which we can't conquer. Whether it be attending a wedding on Zoom, or typically writing an email to a friend, or even I have attended a Zumba class on Google Meet. So we all know that at this point of time, if we share a very positive aroma around us, nothing is impossible. Next. Okay. Now you can see three pictures rolling here. I would like to quote one example in front of all of you. As you see the very first picture of a girl taking a shower. Now, we all have taken inspiration from so many people. And one of them is Angelina Jolie. She broke her silence by crying in the shower. And that is when she kept on telling herself, everything will be all right. It's possible to mend the heart which is broken. And similarly, all of us are aware how to take care of ourselves. So there are some people who find happiness by painting. There are few who really find happiness by clicking pictures from these new Insta updates, which shows you freckles and which show you different kind of features. There are few who really like baking. There are few who like reading. Depends how you cultivate, and everything is possible. Third point for me is when Angelina Jolie can recover and get out, how can't we? So all of us in this virtual lifestyle, if we develop a life which is full of positivity, we all can bloom wherever we plant. See the second picture where there's this guy who is actually cutting his own hair and saying that I have learned from my stylist from FaceTime. And this has really become a trend these days, a fashion statement, right? And just see the third picture, which says it's okay to rest. It's always okay to pause. Just like all of you take a rest when you are just falling from your PUBG game, you all pause and decide to play the next very day. So similarly, take a little rest in life and go ahead so that we develop a pace with our present. So our number two point is walk on the present carpet. Can I have the picture, this slide? Okay. Now I have seen two kinds of people in this lifestyle. number one, who is like literally very happy, like really very happy that I'm able to sleep the way I want. I'm able to, you know, eat my breakfast on time. I'm saving myself from pollution. I'm spending time with my family. And all the happy statements are coming in. Second one is someone who keeps on telling, shit, the way we used to party every Saturday, you know, the way we used to go to horse cars, or the way we used to really go to this hazelnut factory after classes. We are doing nothing. The time is being wasted. As a result, this reminds me, don't let the past blackmail your present to ruin a beautiful future. Because most of us keep on thinking that this is a waste of time. So the carpet which is spread in front of us is all gray. We forgot that this is our time. You can dance on your own rhythm, right? You have your time to wake, to sleep. And the best part is half your stress is gone away thinking what I will wear tomorrow. Next. Okay, now see, the best way to live in the present is to have a takeaway. Always remember. And the wise person always remembers to have a takeaway wherever you are going. And number one point, as Ma'am Kaumudi has also emphasized as we started, be a good listener. And it begins from you. The moment you start listening to your inner voice, that is the moment, trust me, you begin to respect yourself. And when you respect yourself, you will only be able to respect others' voice. Remember that. Point number two, be soft and watch yourself, like what you eat, to what color shirt or lip shade you prefer or you change every fortnight. There are definitely times when girls prefer pastel shades and boys prefer their own kinds of shade. And there comes a time when it's vice versa. So we have to keep watching how time is helping us balance with different modes, just like season. And when we actually understand this, this is how real light begins. Next point, be gentle to it's okay. Be gentle to sensitive issues. The number three point, be the CEO of your life. Yeah. Number three point, be gentle to sensitive issues. I would quote Sharmila Tagore here. She is somebody who will always prefer to be little gentle on issues which are really soft these days. I remember watching her interview where a sensitive question was put and she replied by saying, now the water is under the bridge, so it's all right. And slowly and gradually, that is what helped her to be what she is. Despite all the negativity and positivity which is flowing by, my girls and boys, remember to remember your own self. And when we switch on to that lamp, inner peace drops in. And here is the time when we learn to understand our own self. Now, number three point will begin only the moment we understand ourselves. To be the CEO of your life. And trust me, this virtual lifestyle has given us this platform. Now, you can read this. I am my favorite. And all of us know Geet is known for saying this. Why did I choose this picture? When I was actually putting this picture, I had two points in my mind. Number one, because this girl loved herself so much that she was doing what she wanted. And second point was, she was living in a world full of fantasy, which she imagined. She didn't care, you know, what I will get or what I will not get. Because her relationship with her inner self was very strong. So let's take a minute and roll to the next slide and ask yourself this question. How would you describe yourself in one word? What's your own relationship with your own self? Because many a times, I'm telling you, we fail. And I would say that I was just talking to a student who I'm sure is somewhere around your age. And she told me that I should give her one assignment every day so that she can just be in touch. So I told her that for the first week, just share me how was your day, every day. A bright student, full of shine in her eyes, told me in the evening, "Ma'am, I can't." So I asked her why, because she said, "I can't think about myself." So I told her, just write anything you have in your mind. Breakup, patch up, friendship, loss, betrayal, loneliness, anything. She wrote to me. And she told me something which showed that she has forgotten herself in this journey. And this is when children, we turn into the atmosphere full of anxiety, depression, negativity, stress, because we fail to develop a relationship with ourselves. So I hope with a minute, each one of you helped yourself to describe what's your relation with yourself, right? We often forget to listen to our own self, rather listening to what others are saying or what others think about ourselves. That is the, I think, biggest fashion these days. Next slide. Now, how to develop a relation full of positivity with yourself? Now see, two things which are completely in our hands. Firstly, a sense of organs, and second is our time. If we really club them, we really get a Java chip frappuccino flavor in our life. Remember that, children. Now, all of you know that Starbucks is already in Lucknow now, and we all are waiting for the time when mask-free world begins and we get back and just share our pictures. So for that, let's see another skill. Next slide. What's the skill, right? How do we develop that point, children, to love ourselves instead of focusing on other things? The first point and the first amazing skill is know the difference between need and want. For example, and this is what I read in the Hindu newspaper few weeks back, online editorial, where there was a story where the girl was saying that we all have just adapted a superficial world where we forgot to develop a relationship with ourselves and we forgot what we need and what we want. So she narrated a story where once she was having a real, which she called a real headache. And she knew if she is not gonna have a medicine, certainly she will collapse. Whereas she also wanted to have a chocolate fantasy pastry. And that's when she learned that if she doesn't eat that chocolate fantasy pastry, she won't collapse in life. But if she doesn't eat that medicine, that's when she will collapse. So this virtual lifestyle has also taught us the difference between need and want. We all have learned that firstly, the things which we need, let's buy, because the supermarket will be over with all that stuff, right? So in order to know and to practice that, what do? See, number one point, learn to prioritize yourself by self-caring. Number two point, by first taking admiration from our own parents before looking out of the window. And I'm telling you, this virtual lifestyle is the best way to observe those tiny little things which we have missed, right? And because often we just fail to appreciate what's in our platter. We generally give a list of people we admire, see this person, see that person, but somebody who is just sitting right in front of us, we forget to just get it clicked. Can I have the next slide? Yeah. Now, I would narrate my own example that my first role model has been my father. And when somebody asked me, what's your definition of choosing your prince charming? I always say this line. He is a gentleman and I am a gentleman's daughter. So far, we are equal. Said by Jane Austen from Pride and Prejudice. So for every time when I think about having a soulmate, I think about a person who is just like my father's shadow. So children appreciate what's there right in front of us. Previous slide, please. And number 3 point, expand your horizon. Let's come out of the bubble and be you. For example, if someone talks about you, know that there's something very special in you. Trust me, there's something very special coming to you. That is why somebody is talking about you. And if there's somebody talking about you, know that your beauty, your knowledge, your intellect, nothing will fall down. Feel like a celebrity during that time that, oh yes, like literally somebody is talking about me. So have that attitude. Come out of the bubble of why, but come out how amazing. Next slide, please. Be comfortable in your own skin. The moment you are comfortable with whosoever is talking about you, with whatever you are wearing, with whatever language you are talking. It hardly matters if you are talking in French, Marathi, English, or Hindi. All that matters is your message, the weightage of your message. Like Gandhiji said, my life is my message. And this virtual lifestyle where all of us are pro, we are very good in keeping an upper part of the body intact during all the virtual meet, because now we know how to be comfortable. We just want to grab the opportunity of workshop, to any dance class, to any wedding, or just appear for an exam. All we want is let's be comfortable. Next slide. Okay. Now see, the skill number one, which I have mentioned, to be comfortable in your own skin, is the way you carry yourself becomes a fashion. For example, I have this ball ring, and if I feel like wearing it this way and sitting for the class very comfortably and enjoy, that might turn out to be a fashion to me, right? But if I completely wear and I see, then certainly that means I'm not comfortable, right? So be comfortable. Keep the way you want in your journey of life. Don't lose yourself. Don't think if red is the fashion or pink. What you've carry with confidence becomes your fashion. Next, connecting is an art. Now, I was reading a book where I literally did come across this passage that when we are really open with our strength or weakness, or we say securities and insecurities, that makes you more confident and charismatic around others. The pain of honest confrontation is what generates the trust and respect in your relationships. Now you can see there are a few words which I have marked with pink color, because according to me, those words have been giving me positive rays: confident, charismatic, trust, respect. So I literally enjoyed, like while I was writing this, because all we forget in our journey is to appreciate what we have. We literally stop discussing with ourselves what is the flaw. So my dear girls, boys, and Lucknow University, let's connect. And because of this connect, today we are sitting all of us together in this virtual lifestyle. Learn to understand your securities insecurities, turn those insecurities into securities by being you. Just like the first point was, be comfortable in your own skin. That is when we will be able to develop a life full of quality. Life should be beautiful. It's not that it should be long with your haywire of questions. So let's read another point which says quality versus quantity. Now see, just you can see the picture as this era has rolled out, and all of us now know from 12 invitees to 50 invitees are there in our new normal life. So first thing we actually think is, let's call our main friends, the main whom we call, right? And that is when, if you start learning the difference between your own real friends and your people. Now, what is the difference? Try answering it yourself, children. If you have 50 people in your life and you have two real friends, the day you know this difference, that is when light enters your soul. Always remember. And then only we learn to be around people who are good for our mental health. Next slide, please.
Yes, students, please stay tuned. There is some technical glitch. Ma'am will be back. So talking about the aspect of making connections, be it mentor-mentee connection or a peer-to-peer connection, certainly it's important for all of us to know who are real friends and who are not, so that we can make a clear distinction between with whom we can grow and eventually be a successful person in life. Ma'am has talked about many dimensions of our life in which we can Chiranjeev, please add. Ma'am is trying to reconnect. She's trying to reconnect. Yes. Okay, so ma'am is back.
Okay, I'm sorry. I think there was some connectivity issue. I don't know what has happened.
No problem. No problem, ma'am.
Okay. So the most unpredictable thing, Kaumudi ma'am, is our internet. We all have to learn to be predictable now.
That's okay. Part of being a virtual person now.
Yes. So
nonetheless, we'll continue. Meanwhile, I have a question for you, ma'am. Which is that why the younger generation is prone to easy surrender in a life? Why they are actually, yes, they succumb to the situation very soon. We are witnessing many societies these days. And the problem is not finance, or the problem is not success. Mm-hmm. The problem lies somewhere else, and I want you to discuss on that too.
Okay, perfect. I have few points here also with my PPT. And one thing which I will leave a statement here before I begin with the PPT, that just like Wi-Fi has made our life easier, right? Similarly, it has given us a low patience level, because all the time, everywhere we go, whether it be airport or a cafe, we all want Wi-Fi. And the moment the speed goes off, the moment there is no internet, similarly, our patience level goes down, because we have made our lives much more conditioned that everything should go just like Wi-Fi. Just like the Wi-Fi speed is flowing from Airtel to Airtel fiber, we have moved to for a better speed. Our life should also move in that direction. And that is why our youngsters, I would give example of few celebrities who are very young and have entered the industry. And if they have witnessed success in their first project, they are unable to digest any criticism ahead. Why? Because the very first project gave them success. Now they are unable to take it. We have seen the movie Kedarnath. We have seen another movie called Love Aajkal 2. There was a lot of critics coming out of that movie of Love Aajkal 2, but the actress couldn't take it. So that is what happened with this young generation, that with the flowing of Wi-Fi, with the flowing of everything on our hand, we are paying our bills via internet. Similarly, we want everything to fly off in air. And that's when we start feeling suffocating, because we are not moving out of that comfort zone. We are just sitting in our comfort zone to find everything on our hand, like a speed of the Wi-Fi. And when we don't get, we literally start scribbling over our life. And I have points here, which you told me that things like suicide has come up. And a lot of negativity has been passing on here and there. And it's a human tendency, right? To literally, you know, highlight all the negativity we have actually learned, like literally. Kaumudi ma'am, is the video and the voice, everything okay?
Yes, ma'am, but you can actually turn your video off to decrease the bandwidth in case the network is not proper.
Okay. Is it okay?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay.
You may proceed, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, as we left somewhere around, be around people who are good for your mental health. So similarly, a virtual lifestyle actually taught us that limited number of people in our celebration made us realize that have people who are your main people. We realized that, right? Second issue coming up to us is turn the toughest adjective into a verb, right? Now, I have a quote here, which I'm going to read. Turn the toughest adjective into a verb. How is it possible? Now let's see, we get a clear understanding of who we are by opening ourselves up to new experiences, the same as ours. The more we expose ourselves to different cultures, perspectives, and understandings of how the world outside of our little bubble works, the more our programming gets distorted and the more aware we become of what truly aligns with us. Now, my dear students, and definitely the entire university with us, the faculty, the team, let me tell you, be grateful to them, because today, wherever I'm sitting because of all the tough people I have met. And all the people whom you meet, whom you find, maybe they are weird, maybe they are just hard nut to crack. They are your people, because they give you a new meaning to your life, which you have never thought. The programming of your life changes back then. Somebody who tells you your weak point, trust me to keep them forever in your basket, because they are your true people.
And that is when we start turning from an adjective into the verb to make that life worth living, to start functioning in a virtual lifestyle is what really helped us all this while by being into this scenario. Let's move to the next slide, please. It's okay not to have a plan. Now, let me tell you one thing. All of you, since you all are young, and many a times when I am discussing with my colleague or somebody much elder to me, we always feel clueless, like what we are doing, how life will serve us next month, how unpredictable it is. And trust me, it's okay not to have a plan, because you always meet your original self then. It's totally okay to be clueless sometimes. It calibrates your mind. At least your mind cells really work upon. There are times when we all talk about things like we really don't know which train to catch. But certainly, the moment you actually have a thought, I don't have a plan, what career option to choose, and especially the moment you pass your 12, that is the moment you reach railway station of your life journey. There are a lot of passages, and by your college life, we actually cultivate what to do and what not to. Especially the times when there are two last periods and your teacher tells that, okay, today you have no more classes, and all your group friends decide, let's just go for a movie today. Now the matter comes up here is money. And we start collecting, all right, the bill is 1600, somebody is having 200, somebody is having 300, somebody is... And that random plan turns out to be a fantastic moment of your life, which says that, you know, the best moments are things which you can only feel from inside. So it's always okay not to have a plan. Like, for example, I share this tongue twister with you all of a sudden. Next slide, please. And let's just read it. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Did Peter Piper pick a peck of pickled peppers? If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, there's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked. Now just see for a moment, all of us were so engrossed in saying this tongue twister that we literally didn't think anything around. We were so busy. And that is when you don't have a plan, we begin to see our own real self. So remember, children, this virtual lifestyle has really taught us this. Every day we get a new link of our class. Every day you plan out to cook, because all of us have turned out to be better chefs. All of us have learned something or the other coming out. And that is what happens when we don't have a plan. Instead, we turn that into practice. Like saying it from a simple tongue, which I told you. And the best skill, if really I have to share that with you. Can I have it, please? Okay, I can put my video on because my internet.
Mom, please fix your audio.
Is working
one. Yes.
Very well. Okay. Is it audible now, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, it's audible now.
Okay, I put the video also on. Okay. Because I can see, like, okay, perfect. Now, see, children. The pursuit of happiness in a small jar. Now, I will explain it by actually smiling for 10 seconds and sharing with you a small episode of a series I was watching a few weeks ago, where there's a couple who is in a live-in relationship, and they bought a house. So the girl decides to gift this guy a online menu of a restaurant nearby the new house they have bought. And literally the boy jumped with happiness. Why? because actually his favorite mutton cutlet gravy was in that menu. And that was happiness. If a simple menu can give someone happiness, why can't we find happiness in a small jar? And once I wrote a definition when I was a tiny child, what is happiness to you? And today I did take it out, which says that happiness for me is a treat to my senses, like the smell of a mud during monsoon, catching the first sight of lychee in its season, pampering my taste buds with mother's homemade gajar ka halwa in winter, chirpy voice of birds in the morning, and touching the dew of the flower petals, whereas my happiness equals reality minus expectation. And expectation begins the moment we keep planning and calculating in a long term. So my dear audience, remember to things. Like if you read this card, which says, since I can't see you on your birthday this year, I am sending you this virtual gift. Happy birthday, friend. And that gesture really makes me think that how small things in life can truly make a difference. Trust me. Let's move to another slide. Okay. Now, what is the best skill to find happiness in a small jar? Now, all of us know this girl, Sanam Saeed, known as Kashyap, who literally says here that he gives us many blessings, yet tests us also. I don't know why we never understand this early on in life. Now here, the main skill to understand is to be satisfied with what we have and what we are. And literally this virtual lifestyle taught us to actually enjoy the small pleasures. We have been playing Ludo, to cooking something which was some very new and enjoying it despite sometimes ruining it or decorating it. So these small pleasures of life have really taught us to enjoy small happiness. And the moment you start enjoying small pieces of happiness, that is when the line of challenge begin to teach you to be a phenomenal personality. Always remember. Next slide, please. Rejection and life choices. Now, number one point, as it said, the virtual lifestyle of our laptop in one hand and our mother in front has really helped all of us with multitasking. And each one of us literally learn, you know, to balance it. We all know how the scenario has been, but somehow this multitasking has literally helped us be active in this virtual lifestyle. All of us have worked 18 hours a day initially. All of us have learned the tricks, whether it be Zoom to Google Meet. We have learned to make Google Forms, which we actually used to be, you know, when we were much young, like in college time, we literally used to be very scared to solve such quiz on Google Form. But right now we all are designing those Google Forms. We are writing exams to appearing for interviews in our virtual lifestyle. So all of this has really taught us multitasking. Second is balance between personal and professional life. Now this is when you all went to the college and something unusual happened. Like the teacher refused to take your assignment, or you went to submit your proposal for an internship and the HR person said, no, we are already done and dusted, right? So as a result, what happens that time? That we forget, we quickly unbalance our personal and professional life this way. We cancel all our plans in the evening. We tell our best friend, no, today I'm not in the mood to party. Because we forget to balance and make our life choices beautifully. So remember to balance between personal and professional life. If something unusual happens anytime in personal life, never take that to your college. Never take that to your workplace that I had a fight with my brother and so I'm not talking to anyone in college. Like, absolutely no. Secondly, if you haven't failed, you have missed something in life. Remember this. So rejection is the real test. We all have to pass with distinction. And the last slide is to increase your immunity. And the best way is smile, smile, smile. Till you drop head over heels with your life challenges and make it your signature accessory. So that is what I have to say over how to break a glass with virtual lifestyle. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Skill is a unified force of experience, intellect, and passion in their operation, as quoted by John Ruskin. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this session. The context was contemporary, but the thoughts were concrete and traditional. Next, I would like to request Dr. Savya Sachi, sir, to please come up and say a few words about the session and also present a thanking note to the guest speaker. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Kaumudi. Thank you, Shuaib. It was really nice hearing you. The whole session was very enlightening and probably very thought-provoking. That small jar was really something which we should always look for. We should always look for smaller things to achieve first, and that will make our lives bigger and larger. Smiling, yes, it is very important. Having skill set, achieving a skill set is something which we always look for, but in the meantime we forget who we actually are. And in this tussle of becoming somebody else and losing ourselves, it becomes very difficult to exist. It was really enlightening to hear the answer on mental health. Pardon me. On mental health, that we must have balance within ourselves. With this note, I'm really thankful to Ms. Shoaib, Ms. Kaumudi Singh, our technical assistant Chiranjeev, and all the participants for joining in and being with us for past 40 minutes. As I said, you must have taken something with you, and you must realize that these small takeaways always help us in our lives. It was really to open with thought in our mini series, and I look forward to hearing you again, Ms. Shoaib.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Ma'am, we will take few questions. I wish to discuss the very first question, which was there on your slide, that how do we describe our relationship with ourselves? And we'll take few questions from our participants.
Wonderful.
I want the students to please unmute and answer. Tell your name and class first, and then describe your relation with yourself in a single word or a sentence, maybe. I have also shared a feedback form in the chat box. So you all, please fill that after the valedictory session of this special lecture. Yes, anyone would like to answer? Yes, Ananya Jori from BCA, would you like to answer? Chiranjeev, please allow the students to unmute themselves and speak. Shubham Shrivastav, please unmute. If you want to speak, otherwise, please keep your mic muted. Yes, Aditya Tripathi wants to speak. Yes.
Madam, as the ma'am stated earlier, that the people will talk about you, so feel like a celebrity and take it as a celeb statement. But madam, if somebody is talking about you negatively and leading to the character assassination of your or defaming you in the society, so how can we feel like a celebrity? It will just like a perpetrator, madam, and they are not taking you, they are not ready to take your justification or explanation, because so how can we feel like a celebrity at that situation, madam?
Okay, Aditya Tripathi, thank you for your question. Now you can mute your mic and ma'am will answer your question.
Okay, yes, thank you, Aditya, for this question. Because one thing which I really want to talk about for all of you is, in the meanwhile, where somebody, as he mentioned, is talking against you and still you don't feel like a celebrity. So that time, remember firstly, 2 points. In this journey, the time is not always against us. It will come back to us. And second point is, never lose your goodness in that journey. Like someone said something to you, or someone is putting any allegation to you that you are a complete failure. That doesn't mean that you have to prove yourself by protesting, by shouting. Rather, make it worthwhile by your actions. Prove it by your intellect. That is when all these challenges will go away. And if you have just seen, there are people whom you might have witnessed during in Twitter who are being trolled, but still they don't lose the aim of their life. Right? They keep on going because they know that after one day, spring will also come back to their life. So just keep going. If you are a celebrity, if you feel, in fact, each one of us is a celebrity, whether it be Kaumudi ma'am or Aditya or Akhilesh, anyone sitting here, it's all about our opinion, right? How we take in, and that's all. Anyone else? Kaumudi ma'am, what's your takeaway?
Yes, ma'am, I agree that taking criticism and molding it for the fact that we need to head forward, stay positive, that is very essential, because life is much more than just books, than just being a nice student. It has many folds, and to succeed in life in totality, you need to embrace all the life skills, and you have to be a person with a positive outlook.
Definitely. So
that was the crux of your entire session. If there is other questions also, you can raise your hands and we'll ask Chiranjeev to unmute you. Any more questions?
I think someone is having, Yashasvi is having a question.
Yes.
Okay.
Chiranjeev, please unmute Yashasvi. Yeah, please go forward with a question.
Ma'am, when you're talking about mental health, there is some emotional work that has to be done from within. But sometimes we are not able to adapt to the change that's happening around. The change that's happening around, and by time we get scared, we get we don't have that confidence of standing in front of anyone, standing in front of the mirror even. What can we do then? Because we are not able to adapt to the change.
Okay. Yes, definitely. See, this is something very, a good question you have stated. I would say one thing, the first change begins from within. Always remember, right? And once, if you keep on believing yourself in your dreams, trust me, no one can stop you. No one. And the mental health, which we talk about, few essential ingredients, which if we ignore often, if we take care of it, they will literally be your, trust me, backbone. Number one, the way you eat actually monitors a lot what we all are eating. Trust me, when sometimes we are not functioning properly, our mental health is not right. Like suppose you all are going towards your exam session and 5 days are left. All of us are typically scared. If we start eating chola bhatura every day for dinner, or if we start eating something light around 8 p.m., we eat a light dinner and wind it up. Trust me, it really makes a change. If we try doing things like sun salutation, or maybe just skipping, play a song while you are cooking, or even at home, just breathe in, breathe out. Look from your balcony outside. See the birds chirping or the clouds changing the color. And you will see there's so much in life that because of one small criticism or one imbalance in our life, we are not able to stand firm. So read yourself and begin the change from yourself. Just remain the same person. Don't start losing the luster of your life. Yashasvi. Any more question? There's so many youngsters here. Any question? Anyone? Kaumudi ma'am?
Ma'am, I would like to ask a question.
Yeah. Ma'am, okay, tell me your name, please.
I'm Ahmed Abdullah. I'm from I'm in third year right now.
Okay.
Ma'am, is there any suggestions for improving our speaking skills? Like you were using good words, like giving the HR department example, using the word done and dusted. We know these words. We know these words, but I'm not able to use these in talking, like in simple conversations.
Okay.
So.
Okay, I will give a secret ingredient, Abdullah. Ahmed Abdullah, I think your name is. And to all of you, from the time I joined school, somewhere around like class three, I joined pre-school also, like the time we start gaining, a self-dependent feature. And Ma'am Kaumudi and I have been classmates, and we complete a decade in 2020 to finish our class 10th board. We just appeared for class 10th board in 2010. And see, this is how connectivity works. So now, when I come back to your question, while I was in class three, till date, I have those copies. When I was a child, I started reading from Times of India, Speaking Tree. I moved to Hindustan Times. And then I started reading the Indian Express. I also read magazines like India Today in between. I read a lot of interviews of people. I always read movie reviews. And at present, since almost few years, I have been following The Hindu, the editorial section. So that has really helped me. And whichever line or whichever word, Abdullah, is tough for me, I always write that word. Make a dash. And firstly, I write that sentence from wherever I have read a book, like a magazine, any column, and I make sure then I just see which part of speech it is. And secondly, whenever I watch shows, like maybe any series I'm watching in English, till date, even if I'm watching, I make sure I always keep my copy with myself, so that by the time I finish it, I always see what's my takeaway from that movie and from my vocabulary section. So this is the best way to help your public speaking skills. Second is, use a lot of tongue twisters. If you want to improve your public speaking, take tongue twisters. I've shared one with you in the PPT. And try reading it at a stretch in front of the mirror. Because when you use mirror, you see yourself, your complete posture. Like suppose I am talking and if I say Abdullah, or if I say Abdullah, or if I say Abdullah. So that makes a difference in the public speaking voice. So these are the features like the way you speak, the way you smile, the way your posture is. So all those features. Secondly, to be crisp, to always be gentle while you speak, and have a shape for your speech. Always remember. That will make you an impressive speaker, Abdullah. Any more question or any query, Abdullah? Aditya has, I think, Tripathi, Aditya.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yes. You have said about transform adjective into a verb.
Hmm.
If they are, means the people surrounding us are not using the good adjective, they have a bad meaning like bigoted, radical, and many, there are so many adjectives. So how can we, ma'am, transform or convert that adjective into a verb? Means they are saying bigoted, fundamentalist, radical, as there are so many bad adjectives. So okay. How can, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Just like you prefer eating pizza and samosa over to somebody who is eating turai ki sabzi in his tiffin. Similarly, you have to keep that positivity inside you, despite there is so much negativity either. Right? So even if there are people who are using words like nepotism, or you are saying like so many words coming around, we have to remember who we are. Don't forget the luster. Just like all of us, we know that if at home also our mother till date makes a typical veggies, then we are never ready to eat. We want our pizza platter or our own fries. Same way, let the world follow whatever they are. You don't have to lose yourself. Yes, any more query?
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. I think time will allow us to take that much of questions only.
Perfect.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for this session. And I hope the students are enriched by your talk. We look forward to have you again.
Thank you.
As I see that students are interested to hear more from you. So me and Dr. Savya Sachi both thank you for joining us. Thank you so much, ma'am. We wind up the session by this.